I'm Professor Norman Clark of the Open University. Over the past year or so, many people have asked me to explain Brexit. As an economist, they feel I have some sort of formulaic answer, but I don't, and I don't think anyone does. What I can do, however, is to make some suggestions about why I think all this has happened. Some have argued that it may be connected to the loss of empire and the feeling Britain has lost its rightful place in the world. Vague memories of bygone days when Britain ruled the international economy through free trade became increasingly contrasted with resentment over European rule by the Eurocrats in Brussels. Others have focused more on the related belief that the share of the state in national economic activity has become too great. And by extension, therefore, the European Union, the EU, has become part of an increasing problem whereby decisions are made by unelected people. Yet others argue that the European project itself has been mishandled by powerful vested interests on the part of elites across the whole of the EU. My own view is that while each of these views are present, the core at the bottom is economic. Populations have become disenfranchised despite some limited economic growth. The result is a search for those responsible for what is seen as a lack of fairness, a small section of society becoming fabulously rich while most of the rest of us are constrained economically. What brought things to a head were first the banking crisis that hit in 2007-2008, and second, an apparent increase in immigration, often from poorer parts of Europe. And membership of the EU has been seen as a major part of the problem. Of course, immigration has become a problem all over Europe, and sensible controls were warranted. But the issue of immigration has become a focus for something much deeper. A hollowing out of living standards that affects many regions and increasingly significant proportions of all classes, including the middle class, in the UK as a whole. What is noteworthy is that we have been through all this before, at the time of the 1929 stock market crash. Rapid decline of economic activity and the severe recession of the 1930s. For the economics profession in those times, the problem was like a household living beyond its means. Countries should tighten their belts, consume less, and save more. To encourage that to happen, national treasuries, led by the USA, advocated what is now known as austerity. Interest rates were hiked to prohibitive levels, public spending massively cut, with the results we all know about. Falling investment brought about fewer jobs and diminishing incomes in an endless cycle of impoverishment that was only preventable by government action. But such action became harder to achieve as both productivity and incomes fell. Aggregate tax revenues diminished and things continued to spiral down. For the great economist John Maynard Keynes, austerity policies like these were misconceived, since they ended up mismanaging resources and increasing poverty and inequality. He called it the fallacy of composition. Economic systems are not like households, and they operate quite differently. Instead, he advocated fiscal policies to stimulate demand and pay for these through measures like progressive taxation. Unfortunately, his arguments were resisted by the economics profession, and the resultant depression was only halted by the Second World War at enormous human cost. Austerity clearly did not work then, nor has it been working now, although the contextual circumstances are different, including levels of private debt, which have reached unprecedented levels in many countries, including the UK, the USA, Japan, and China. Economists and those who advise governments have clearly forgotten Keynes. It can't be denied that the economic stagnation faced by many people in the country has become very real. I'm of the belief the policies that have been instituted to deal with these problems have not worked. There's little doubt in my mind that austerity has produced a general level of investment and economic performance at one of the lowest levels in Western Europe. In a sense, immigration has become a scapegoat for economic decline. In contrast, we are finding out from most economic sectors in the UK that we are very much in need of immigrants to fill unfilled vacancies in many sectors across the UK, including health, agriculture, industry, and construction. In my view, therefore, a radical shift in economic perspective is now needed to rebalance an economic system that has clearly lost its sense of perspective and direction.
get more from the Open University? Check out the links on screen now.